Welcome to St. Paul and St. Stephen's Church, Gloucester, on this Trinity Sunday. We come together to worship God, to bring our praises in music and in prayer. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, three in one and one in three. Wherever you join us, you are most welcome. And we gather in the presence of the one true God. We meet in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. We say together the prayer of preparation. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. God the Father forgives us in Christ and heals us by the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore put away all anger and bitterness, all slander and malice, and confess our sins to God our Redeemer. Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Holy God, faithful and unchanging, enlarge our minds with the knowledge of your truth and draw us more deeply into the mystery of your love, that we may truly worship you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. First reading this morning comes from Isaiah chapter 6, verses 1 to 8. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne, high and lofty, and the hem of his robe filled the temple. Seraphs were in attendance above him, each had six wings, with two they covered their faces, and with two they covered their feet, and with two they flew. And one called to another and said, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. The pivots on the threshold shook at the voices of those who called, and the house filled with smoke. And I said, Woe is me, I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I live among a people of unclean lips. Yet my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. Then one of the seraphs flew to me, holding a live coal that had been taken from the altar with a pair of tongs. The seraph touched my mouth with it and said, Now that this has touched your lips, your guilt has departed and your sin is blotted out. Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, Whom shall I send, and who will go for us? And I said, Here am I, send me. And our second reading comes from Romans chapter 8, verses 12 to 17. So then, brothers and sisters, we are debtors, not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received a spirit of adoption. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. If in fact we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Now there was a Pharisee named Nicodemus, a leader of the Jews. He came to Jesus by night and said to him, Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one can do these signs that you do apart from the presence of God. Jesus answered him, Very truly I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God without being born from above. Nicodemus said to him, How can anyone be born after having grown old? Can one enter a second time into the mother's womb and be born? Jesus answered, Very truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of water and spirit. What is born of the flesh is flesh, and what is born of the spirit is spirit. Do not be astonished that I said to you, you must be born from above. The wind blows where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus said to him, How can these things be? Jesus answered him, Are you a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand these things? Very truly I tell you, we speak of what we know and testify to what we have seen, yet you do not receive our testimony. If I have told you about earthly things and you do not believe, how can you believe if I tell you about heavenly things? No one has ascended into heaven except the one who descended from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. At the heart of this Gospel reading, in verse 16, For God so loved the world, he sent his only Son. We see the Trinity in action, the Creator, the Redeemer, and the Sustainer together. The Redeemer does not come of his own volition, but is sent by the Creator and comes about in earthly form by the power of the Spirit, who sustains both mother and child as they grow, are born, and mature into adulthood. It is the Creator at work on the cross, even when it looks like devastation, and it is the Spirit who sustains the Redeemer even in that darkest of moments. It is the Creator and the Spirit that brings the Redeemer up from the depths of hell and death into a new life. It is the Creator and the Sustainer who bear the Redeemer back to have authority over all things. And it is the Creator, the Redeemer, and the Sustainer that invite us each and every day to have eternal life, to live our lives in every moment as in the unending presence of God. It is the Trinity at work that leads us to notice the things of God rather than the things of flesh, and respond to the answers we get when we have questions, particularly that question, whom shall I send and who will go for me? Note, it is a question posed to Isaiah, but it could equally be a question posed to Jesus or to you and I. I wonder what our answer is. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Trusting in that promise, we say together the words that affirm our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. Let us pray for the needs of God's world and give thanks to him for his love so freely given. Loving God, we thank you for the beauty and wonder of your creation. Help us to love and respect all that you have made, to share your gifts with our brothers and sisters in need, and to protect and nurture all that is fragile and vulnerable on this earth. Loving God, we thank you for the huge diversity of peoples who share this world. We pray for a renewed spirit of longing for peace and reconciliation wherever there is conflict, injustice and oppression. Help us to do what we can to bring peace into our own lives and to seek your ways of peace for the welfare of all your children. Loving God, we thank you for the love and fellowship of friends and families. Help us to be generous with our time, with our love and with ourselves, to care for all who are lonely and in need of our support. Pray for ourselves as we begin to stretch our wings and come out of lockdown. May we tread gently and go carefully. Loving God, we thank you for all who work to improve care and treatment of those who are physically ill or mentally distressed. We pray that your loving and healing presence will surround all who are suffering today, and that your Holy Spirit will comfort and uphold them throughout their troubles. We pray for all who have died, those we know, those unknown to us, and those known only to you. May they rest in peace and rise in glory, and may your love and peace surround their families. Loving God, we offer you our prayers, trusting that in your love you will use them and us for the fulfillment of your purpose for your creation. Give us courage to be part of your answer to prayer, and when you ask, "Whom shall I send?" free us from fear that we may answer, "Here am I, send me." Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. We say together, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and for ever. Amen. And a blessing. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.